Hi, this is Jody from Switzerland with another knife review, and today we're looking at a new release from CRKT for 2022. And this is a very odd knife, and it's actually a second variation of a knife that CRKT has already released a couple of years back, and it is called the Ripsnort 2. This is a Philip Booth design, looks quite a bit like the original Ripsnort, but I think it's certainly a design improvement. This is a thumb stud opening folder. The original Ripsnort was a flipper design, and it had also a cutout here at the end where you had exposed liners, and that certainly was some kind of a ergonomic nightmare back there. But it certainly is a very interesting overall design, and this is certainly also a pretty hefty and quite large folder here from CRKT, and normally not something I am very interested in, but I really like some of the stuff they did here on this folder. And let's dive into the specs of the CRKT Ripsnort 2 that we have right here. So we have an overall length on this knife of 8.28 inches or 21 centimeters with a blade length of 3.48 inches or 8.8 centimeters. The steel is 8CR 13 MOV and the blade stock thickness is at 3.2 millimeters. The handle length is 4.81 inches or 12 centimeters and the handle scales are GFN with some stainless steel inserts on both sides with some texturing, and then we got some massive stainless steel liners as you can see right here. It runs on IKBS bearings and is a thumb stud opener and has a tip down pocket clip, a skeletonized pocket clip there that is not repositionable. You also got a lanyard hole here in the back. So this is the Ripsnort. We have a weight on this knife of 173 grams or 6.1 ounces. So this is certainly quite a hefty folder, one of the heaviest I have held in a long time. And the price here is just under $50 for the Ripsnort 2. So this is a very odd looking knife. It has a bit of the cleaver vibe going on, and it just kind of spoke to me in terms of the overall design. I wanted to check it out. I wanted to feel how it feels in hand, and the ergonomics are one of the high points of this folder. This really feels to me like a great kind of shop knife, beater knife to have around the house to do the dirty jobs with, and you still have a very cool overall design that gives you some enjoyment. Very, very cool overall styling with this stippled thumb stud on both sides together with those stainless steel inlays in this very cool texture GFN handle. So this is like a wood grain texture on the GFN. I said it in a couple of reviews that CRKT does the best kind of GFN on the market on these budget friendly folders. It never feels cheap. It always has something interesting to offer you, and I think this kind of bark style finishing on the GFN really looks good and also gives you something to hold on to, and also feels not cheap. So that's certainly an achievement when using GFN. Of course, I would love to see them use G10 or some higher end materials. Of course, my card would look great on a burly design like this, but that is certainly just a thing with CRKT. They like to use GFN, they like to use for 2022 a bit subpar budget steels like 8CR or 1.4116. That is certainly an area where CRKT can improve. They could use 14C28N or some other steels like Nitro V that have been used on lesser expensive folders. That would be something I would love to see from CRKT, because they have some great designs, great collaborations with lots of well-known knife makers. And if they could up the steel game, that would certainly give them a much larger overall buying audience. And also the enthusiasts would certainly look long and hard to get another CRKT. But as it stands, they still have great designs. And I think I want to have a little bit of a balance in the overall content I offer here at the channel, and that's why I also take a look at these lesser expensive folders with some lower end steels. But the Ripsnort certainly is a fun folder. This is really, nothing fancy would say, second type of cool. This is just a burly, beefy folder. I love the blade shape. The branding is done quite toned down for CRKT's standard only booth design. I don't know why they always put those serial numbers on there. Nobody needs them on the blade. I would love to see the steel marking instead of that. But that's just how it is. And you see the action and the detent here on this rip snort is actually very impressive. So it fires out, it's very loud and nice and smooth with that heavy blade, false closed. And it looks great in the closed position as well. So really cool overall design here, comes pretty much center, maybe a tiny bit to the lock bar side there. And no play in any direction, very, very solid. I wasn't able to open it with my middle finger because it has a pretty strong detent. I think I can show that to you. Pretty strong detent to shoot it out like this. Ergonomically, it fits very well in the hand here. You can see I have small to medium hands. I can get two fingers in this forward choil and two fingers in the back choil, and I'm very, very comfortable, but a bit far away from the blade. I could also choke up, but then there is not really a good spot. I can put my finger on here, but it isn't really meant for that, and I can't go too much forward because there is no real spot there. But in the regular kind of hammer grip or just the saber grip, it actually feels quite well, but my thumb lands in front of that jimping, so that doesn't really have a lot of functionality there. In terms of the clearing of the plunge grind, they have done that very well, and because you have a very tall blade with that flat ground bevel, it actually comes down to a pretty thin cutting edge. And you can also see here in the front a nice tip in that cleaver. So overall, a very, very well done here. In the overall construction here, you can see the lockup of this massive, massive liner lock that certainly also contributes to the overall weight of 6.1 ounces, which is certainly much heavier than something I would carry. So this will be a kind of around the house shop knife for the dirtier tasks for me. But if you like burlier, heavier folders, I think 6.1 ounces is certainly something you can carry, but you will notice this knife also because it's actually quite a thick boy in the pocket. So you have thick GFN scales as well as thick stainless steel liners. That certainly also makes for an overall thick feel in the pocket, but also a nice hand feeling feel when you're using the knife. That's always a little bit of a trade-off there. You can see we have a extended lock bar right there, so very easy to disengage that liner lock. That's certainly done very well, and it doesn't really create a hot spot or anything while holding the knife. One thing that is a bit of a downside on the Rip Snort 2 here is the pocket clip. For one, it's only tipped down because you have a little bit of a slender butt end here, but if you eliminate that lanyard hole, you could also do it in a tip up fashion. And I like these stainless steel inlays with the nice texturing that harken back to the textured thumb stud, but they have done them underneath the clip here. And that can certainly shred your pockets over time, and the clip also has quite a bit of strength to it, so I think the clip could have been done better. CRKT has been known the last couple of years to do some great clips, and on most of their models it's really well done, but here I think they have clashed a little bit with the overall aesthetic design. I would love to see a tip up clip and not a clip that lands on this textured stainless steel, and a little bit some ease up on the tension of that clip would be better. It still works, but you certainly notice that it is a clip that could need some improvement. We have a GFN backspacer right there, and let's do some size comparisons on the Rip Snort. So it is a larger folder. Let's do our standard Shirogorov sandwich, F95NL at the top and Neon Zero at the bottom, and you can see it is a bit shorter than the F95 and a bit larger than the Neon Zero, so certainly mid to large size here on the Rip Snort. And then we have our Benchmark EDC blades, full size Benchmade Bug Out, which looks quite small against the Rip Snort, and then we have a Para 3. and you can see also quite larger than a Para 3. And here you will see the thickness of the rip snort in terms of the handle. So this is certainly a pretty chunky knife in the pocket, about one scale thicker than a regular kind of Spyderco Para 3. And you can also see it is also a tall knife, about as tall as a Para 3, a little bit less. So this is a bit of a bricky, blocky knife in the pocket. But that's also a bit of the charm of this folder if you compare it to something lightweight and thin like the Bugout. It's about as thick as two Bugouts strapped together. So certainly a fun, heavy, bricky and burly knife. But if you're somebody that likes these kinds of folders, I think this could be one that is fun to have at an inexpensive price of under $50. Some other comparisons I have for you is, for example, the K320 by Sig Sauer and Hoke. Also one of my larger, more burly folders. And then we have a Boecker Bullpup, a heavy, smaller folder here, and also a thicker folder if you take a look at the thickness comparison here to the Bullpup, which is a great Boecker Plus folder. You can see it's closer, but the rip snort is still a bit thicker there, and the rip snort is certainly noticeably heavier because there's lots and lots of steel on this folder. So overall, I have to say the action is probably the nicest thing about this folder. Very authoritative thwack when it opens up. Solid lockup, great overall blade shape, very good looking, very different, good ergonomics overall. For some like more cruder task, if you want to get up there and do some fine work, it's a bit large for that. Big disappointment on that pocket clip with the tension and landing on that textured stainless steel. Very interesting and well executed GFN texturing. But overall, this is a knife that if you like the design and you know what you're getting into with this heavy, large folder, I think you could have quite a bit of fun with this folder. But there are certainly better knives for just regular EDC carry and use out there from CRKT, but also from other makers. So this is certainly a design-driven folder, but overall executed pretty well if you can overlook the materials used and the subpar pocket clip. So I hope you could get a good feel for the CRKT rip snort designed by Philip Booth, and you now know if you want to get that or not for your own collection. So if you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up. Follow me here on YouTube as well as on Instagram at 7ready_knife_reviews. And if you're looking to buy some new knives, please consider White Mountain Knives and use my discount code 7ready to get 10% off your entire order. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.